Hello, Brewtubers, and welcome to my little Oktoberfest, not fest, beer tasting review thing. Hooray! Woo! So, I brewed two beers for an Oktoberfest festival. Yes, Oktoberfest beer festival, whatever you want to call it. An Oktoberfest party. There we go, that sounds nice. So yes, brewed two beers, an Oktoberfest beer from the Bible and a German Pilsner, which was adapted from the Bible recipe, I think. So yes, I brewed two beers. I was going to have a few family around to celebrate, but then obviously all this COVID thing didn't help, so ended up not doing it this year, which was a shame. But I had the beers, so let's do the beer tasting review. I have my Stein. Hooray! Oh, this is the Oktoberfest beer. It's pretty clear now, actually. Very heavy as well. It does smell like an Oktoberfest beer, which is good. Sort of that sort of quite malty lager character. So, love the colour. Sort of nice amber. Sort of colour to it. Carbonation level is, you can't, I suppose you can just about see a little bit of reflection. Quite nicely done. So the head's sticking around a bit. Obviously it was a lot bigger head when I started the video, but still there. Let's taste it, shall we? Hooray! Quite chilly, actually. Got the keys are set to 6 degrees Celsius, so a little bit on the chilly side, but probably about right for a lager. So my thoughts, it's very drinkable. I'm actually quite surprised at how close to some of the Oktoberfest commercial beers I've got with this. The Oktoberfest lagers, in the most part, are actually very tasty beers. And they're quite well made, you know, lagers. And this is comparable. It reminds me of something like the Bock I made when I sort of first started brewing. It's a very malty, malty beer. I do wish I used a smaller glass over this because it's very heavy. Never mind. So yes, flavour profile. It's obviously quite malty, as I said. There's a sort of a honey flavour to it. And there's a little bit of sort of like molasses, black treacle sort of taste as well. Just lurking in the background. Quite crisp and clean as well. Very clean sort of finish to it. Obviously it's a malt forward beer, so not much in the way of hops. Probably a tiny hint of a sort of grassy bitterness to it, but you know, it's all about the malt in this beer. And as I say, you get a nice sort of whack of honey. And caramel. Obviously a bready doughiness as well. And yes, there's sort of a darker, as I said, black treacle taste to it, which is not very strong, but it's just nicely there in the background and complements the beer very nicely. That's sort of the finishing taste, is that sort of dark treacle flavour. And you get the doughy honey taste on the forefront. Well, it is jolly good. I'm happy with that. I'm very happy with that. I will definitely brew that beer again. As I said, it's just the Bible recipe, scaled up for 40 litres. I used the proper Oktoberfest yeast strain as well. I think it was a Y Why yeast is it? Oh, I can never remember him now. Yeah, so it's the Oktoberfest yeast strain and the recipe from the Bible. I've done a video on it, so if you want to know more details about the actual recipe, watch that. My advice would be to brew it a lot earlier than I brewed this, because I think I brewed this in September, I think. And yeah, oops, not really been ready to drink properly until, well, this is probably the best, sorry, the CO2 is repeating on me. This is probably the best I've had it. So yeah, it's now November the 8th. Yep, 8th of November. So obviously completely missed Oktoberfest, which was a whole month ago. Because obviously Oktoberfest is the start of October and the end of September, I think, isn't it? So yeah, completely missed Oktoberfest with this. Brewed it far too late. But I'm glad I did do it, because if obviously 2021 is a better year for social gatherings, I'll definitely rebrew this one. In fact, I do have a spare keg I've not opened, so I may keep the keg until next year, possibly. Saves me brewing it next year. But no, I'm very pleased with how this has turned out. It's a very tasty beer. It's 5.6%. So it's a hard hitter. Yes, couldn't have too many steins of this. But yes, it's turned out very well. I'm pretty happy with it. And yes, I shall finish this off and then move on to the German Pilsner. Wow, exciting. So on to beer two, which is the German Pilsner. The head hasn't stayed around much. I literally only just poured this and the head's pretty much gone. So nice yellowish colour to it. Slightly hazy, but you know, it's not bad at all. You can see like the marking from the other side of the glass. Smells very sweet and doughy. And I've also got some Germanic snacks. Well, they're actually American, even though it says Cinders of Hanover. They're American, but well, Hanover is a German state, isn't it? Obviously, the King of Great Britain used to be the Kings of Hanover as well at once upon a time. But very nice, these ones. Very cheesy snacks, but very oily as well. Crunchy. Nice, but a little bit too oily. Cheddar cheese flavour. Apparently there's a mustard one, ham and mustard, I think, which is apparently very nice. I don't like mustard, but my friend, who also doesn't like mustard, said that the ham and mustard ones were quite good. So yes, American snack, but with the word Hanover and a pretzel, which is German. So really, it's a very tenuous link indeed, but never mind. Sod the snacks, let's get on to the beer. So yes, the German Pilsner. If I remember rightly, there's a lot of pearl hops in this, and some Herzbrücker. Hallertauer Herzbrücker. Probably pronounced that all wrong, but never mind. So yes, let's dive in. As a lesser nose, quite a sweet nose to it. Malty. Yes, drink. It's pretty tasty, actually. My strongest criticism of this beer is that it's a little bit too sweet. It's 4.7%, but it was supposed to be, so I think, something like 6%. Certainly mid-fives to six. percentage wise, it just didn't attenuate well. I partly believe that might be because I mashed it to higher temperature. I can't remember exactly what temperature I mashed it at. I'd have to check the video, but I think it was something like 67 degrees Celsius. Probably should have dropped that down to 65, perhaps even 64. To also get less of the residual sugars and unbreakable chains. You know what I mean. Or if you don't, yes. So, I think I mashed this a little bit too high so that it has too many complex sugars which the yeast can't break down, which has led to a sweeter beer than anticipated. That will do. You can tell I've had a stein of 5.6% Oktoberfest beer. Anyway. So yes, let's actually get on to this beer, shall we? So it's a little bit on the sweet side, like a, it's like a sort of candy for the children, a candy sweetness to it. It's quite sort of a ready doughy, malty sort of sweetness as well. As well as that sort of candy drop, pear drop. Oh yeah, pear drop, perhaps, possibly. Anyway, a little bit too sweet for the style, but I know what to do next time. It does have a crisp, slightly dry finish. And it does have a good hop presence about it. Yeah, actually it does have a dryish finish. But yeah, the hoppiness is quite pleasant. It's say it's like the German noble hops, so it's fairly grassy, hay-like, you know, the sort of typical Pilsner hop profile you get. It tastes like a Pilsner. It's just a bit of a sweet Pilsner, is all. You can drink that quite happily. The bready, doughy sweetness, maltiness is a bit more prevalent, but you know, there's still some of the hop profile about it as well. It would be a very well balanced beer if I had less sweetness to it. If I had mashed at a lower temperature, it would be obviously a little bit less sweeter and probably taste better balanced. As it stands, it's drinkable, but it's not bad. It's not bad. It's the sweetness isn't a problem. It's just, it would be better balanced if it wasn't as sweet. So the carbonation levels are quite good because it's repeating on me. I'm not sure if you can see the carbonation in there. It does look quite flat actually, doesn't it? But there is carbonation in there. It's not heavily carbonated, but I can see bubbles. I can see bubbles. Very fine little bubbles. But yes. Yeah, it's a good beer. So clean, crisp, dry finish. But it's just a little bit too sweet on the foreground. Not bad at all. Not bad at all. Right, well, I'm just waffling now. Waffle, waffle, waffle. So I shall call it video done at this stage. And I shall probably see you again next week for another Brew Day video. I was thinking about doing my Old London Porter next weekend, but I may push the boat out and do something like my Citra Mosaic Pale Ale. The first lot I did for commercial sale was alright, you know, it sold, I did alright, but for me, it just finished a little bit too bitter for my own personal taste. So the next lot, I'm going to add a tiny bit of lactose and just cut down slightly on the hopping rate. And I think that'll make a better beer. So I'm going to keg and cask that, I think. And obviously have the keg first in the clubhouse and see what I think of it. If I think the keg's good, I'll offer the cask for sale to one of the local bottle shops to see how they get on with. So that's the plan. So yes, I shall finish my rather nice, if a tiny bit too sweet, Pilsner off, and my American Germanic snacks, and yes, I shall see you soon, perhaps next week. Bye-bye. Oh, Proust!